Akdeniz'e geçmek için hiç düşünmeden hayatlarını tehlikeye atan binlerce göçmenin yaşadığı dram, Avrupa Birliği'nde derin bir krize yol açtı. Geçtiğimiz seneden bu yana Avrupa Komisyonu Avrupa Göç Gündemi başlığı altında bir çalışma yürütüyor. Bu çalışma dahilinde krize karşı alınması gereken acil önlemler kadar gelecek yıllarda göç konusunda her yönüyle daha iyi idare edebilmek için atılması gereken adımlar da belirleniyor. Gündemin ilk sırasında ise Suriyeli mültecilere yapacağı yardım konusunda Türkiye ile varılan anlaşma var. Türkiye'yi desteklemek için bu yaz eğitim, sağlık, kentsel ve sosyal altyapı alanlarının yanı sıra krizden en çok etkilenen 10 şehrin sosyoekonomik seviyesinin yükseltilmesine yönelik 1.415 milyar euro değerinde bir özel önlem paketinin uygulamaya konulmasına karar verildi. Avrupa Birliği'ne göç krizi aylardır gündemi meşgul ediyor. İşte bu anlatacaklarımız da şimdiye dek olan bitenin iç yüzüne dair.
This is a very deep crisis. This is a crisis that is about real interest, but it's also about identity, and it's about important political principles.
We have a European Union policy which was a fair weather policy, and we were in 2015 in a perfect storm.
Je l'ai dit au Parlement luxembourgeois, la migration sera le point fort de notre présidence.
Chaque État membre seul ne pourra pas régler cette question. C'est très difficile, la situation est très difficile. Mais on espère bien qu'on finira avec le temps par trouver une solution.
In the spring of 2015, we saw that we had not just the central Mediterranean route, but we also had the eastern Mediterranean route, and suddenly it was clear that we would be facing a number of migrants which was absolutely unprecedented.
migrants, peut-être plus, le pire drame de l'immigration en Méditerranée.
Una tragedia senza precedenti a 60 miglia dalla costa libica.
I still remember that the accident was on a weekend. We went to the ministers of foreign affairs and ministers of interior. One of the major points was actually the trebling of the amounts available for Frontex operations in order to move towards saving lives on the central Mediterranean route.
Let me say that having 41 European Union ministers sitting together at the same table with less than 24 hours notice is not just a sign of goodwill, but also and finally gives the idea of a new sense of urgency.
Depuis plusieurs mois, on sait que c'est un sujet majeur et que donc là on se dit, on l'a vu, c'est pas quelque chose qu'on découvre et on ne peut pas empêcher de tels drames, on ne peut pas empêcher de tels événements tragiques. Et là, c'est vraiment une prise de conscience que tout ce que l'on a dit, et l'on a dit beaucoup de choses, n'aboutit pas au résultat que nous attendons, c'est-à-dire éviter ces drames et contenir la pression migratoire.
Saving the lives of innocent people is of course the number one priority for us. It will be a discussion about readiness to sacrifice some national interests for the common good. And this is always here the most challenging moment in our discussions.
La première décision qui est attendue, c'est de renforcer la présence de l'Europe en mer, mais également en surveillance.
Es geht hier um die Akzeptanz der Europäischen Union, ihrer Werte weltweit, und deshalb ist das Thema heute von allergrößter Wichtigkeit, gerade auch im Blick auf das Retten von Menschenleben.
I to jest moment, w którym Unia może pokazać swoją solidarność nie tylko w słowach, ale również w bardzo konkretnych czynach.
À partir de ce moment-là, on a sauvé davantage de personnes, ce qui est évidemment un objectif fondamental, mais on a vu également de plus en plus de personnes arriver. Les routes ont changé, puisqu'on est passé de la Méditerranée centrale à la partie davantage à l'est.
It started out being about saving lives. Next, it became a matter of how do we do with the people who actually set foot on European territory? How do we redistribute them among member states?
I remember a discussion in Coreper when I said to the ambassadors, yes, we will save these people, but now then we need to know what we do with them.
La règle qui s'applique, c'est que le pays auprès duquel des migrants arrivent est responsable du traitement des demandes d'asile. Mais lorsque l'on a des milliers de migrants, on voit bien le poids énorme que cela peut représenter pour les pays de première entrée. Donc l'idée est assez rapidement venue de se partager cette responsabilité.
We already in mid-May said that we would propose a relocation scheme, and then we had a rather difficult discussion between member states. Because there was this feeling that these measures should be decided on a voluntary basis. And so we had the camps, voluntary versus mandatory.
Il y a des histoires différentes dans nos États membres. Dans les pays de l'Est de l'Europe, il n'y a pas de grande tradition récente, en tout cas d'immigration importante. Cette ouverture n'est pas quelque chose de naturel et de spontané.
Réellement, les pays de l'Est ont des sociétés plus homogènes. Il y a une crainte, une peur du différent.
Povinné kvóty nebudú. Zopakujem to ešte raz, povinné kvóty nebudú. Nikto nemôže povedať ani Českej republike, ani Slovenskej republike, toľkoto a toľkoto musíte teraz migrantov zobrať v takéto a v takéto kvalite.
We would like to be honorable with the immigrants also, because we cannot force them to go to the country they don't want.
There's also a dimension related to how attractive member states are as end destination for refugees. And therefore, I think that seeing this only in East-West terms is a gross simplification.
Les migrants donnent parfois l'impression de choisir. Donc, un des arguments des pays de l'Est de l'Europe consiste à dire « mais ces migrants ne veulent pas venir chez nous », ce qui n'est pas complètement faux.
So we had this difficult debate between the ones who thought they had already too many migrants or the ones who said that they did not have any experience.
On a vu cette crispation. À un certain moment, j'ai mis tous les ministres autour de la table sont diplomates et je leur ai dit « donnez-moi un nombre ».
Il y a une première décision avec 40 000 personnes dans un contexte où le Conseil européen avait dit qu'il fallait décider par consensus, qu'il n'y aurait pas de décision brutale à l'égard des États membres qui avaient des difficultés.
Pour la relocalisation, 40 000 à répartir, on était bloqué à 33 000. Voilà, c'était déjà un signal. Sur la base volontaire, pour moi en tout cas, on n'arrivera jamais à répartir plus de réfugiés.
So the summer came, and end of July, August, we had massive influx via the Greek islands, which meant that President Juncker, on the 9th of September, actually in his State of Union address, announced that we would come with a new relocation proposal of 120,000.
Il faut quand même partir du début du mois de septembre. Aylan, ce garçon de 5 ans, qui est mort, allongé mort sur la plage, c'était déjà fort. J'avais l'espoir jusque peut-être quelques heures avant cette réunion qui était à 3 heures qu'on était capable de trouver une solution donc sur base politique disons. Alors à un certain moment j'ai vu que ça ne marchait pas.
Et donc la présidence sous la pression de la nécessité de réagir, il faut réagir, on ne peut pas passer des mois à discuter ce genre de proposition. Le traité nous donne un outil qui est la majorité qualifiée.
Alors j'ai dit à certains d'entre nous, des ministres, j'ai dit, si ça ne passe pas, je passe au vote. Il y avait même à ce moment-là des gens des pays de l'Est qui m'ont dit, passe au vote, parce que pour nous c'est plus facile si c'est par vote que si on doit trouver un consensus. C'était pas facile, il fallait une majorité qualifiée.
Donc la présidence dit, voilà, nous allons nous compter et l'on verra. Les États savent que c'est la règle du jeu, que ça ne leur fait pas particulièrement plaisir d'être mis en minorité, mais ils doivent s'y conformer.
Si on passe au vote et qu'on prend la décision, c'est une loi européenne. Il n'y a personne qui peut dire « moi, je n'applique pas ».
La relocalisation se fait une fois que les personnes, les migrants, sont arrivés dans ce que l'on appelle les « hotspots », c'est-à-dire des endroits où l'on doit les enregistrer, identifier quels sont les vrais demandeurs d'asile et ceux qui sont plutôt des migrants économiques. Donc ça prend beaucoup de temps. Et puis, parfois, les migrants refusent de se faire enregistrer, ne veulent pas passer par ces zones, ces hotspots.
When you have a smuggler saying to you, in 2 days' time, or 3 days' time, if you pay me 2,000 euros, I can get you to Munich, to Vienna, or you have to go in a relocation process, not knowing whether you actually are going to end up in Luxembourg or in Sofia. A lot of the migrants take the other choice.
Il y a beaucoup d'argent qui se fait avec des organisations criminelles dans des conditions vraiment extrêmement choquantes. Donc les passeurs leur disent, faites attention, ne vous faites pas enregistrer.
Il faudrait qu'on explique la relocalisation, ce que c'est. Ce n'est pas les mettre dans un avion et dans un camp. Non, mais c'est leur donner une chance pour pouvoir refaire leur vie dans un pays de l'Union européenne.
Nous accordons l'asile à des personnes qui sont menacées dans leur existence, dans les pays en situation de guerre, de conflit. Donc les personnes qui n'ont pas vocation à recevoir l'asile, normalement, doivent rentrer dans leur pays d'origine.
Il y avait des jours, au mois de novembre, où il y a eu des arrivées, 20 000 personnes sont venues rien que par Lesbos. C'est terrible. Hein. La Grèce a peur que d'énormes camps de réfugiés non relocalisables et non retournables se rassemblent donc en Grèce. Ça, c'est une peur qui m'a toujours été bien expliquée et je comprends, je comprends.
It became clear that without stemming the flows, without getting down the numbers, we would simply not be able to cope with this crisis.
We have now reached a critical point. Today, we are talking about millions of potential refugees trying to reach Europe. In light of this, the most urgent question is how to regain control of our external borders.
As I see it, the summit on the 23rd of September was a key point in the development of the approach to the crisis. We thought that it was very important to broaden the agenda. What can we do in terms of making sure that once refugees come to Europe, that they are registered in hotspots, that we know who they are? What can we do to strengthen border controls? What can we do in cooperating with Turkey?
Dieser EU-Türkei-Plan wird auf der einen Seite deutlich machen, dass wir aus vielerlei Gründen enger mit der Türkei zusammenarbeiten werden. Denken wir nur an den Bürgerkrieg in Syrien, an den Kampf gegen IS, aber auch an die illegalen Migrationsbewegungen.
One of the complexities of dealing with this crisis is that this is not something we can just deal with within the Union. We need the African partners, and for those coming via the Eastern Mediterranean route, we need Turkey.
Turkey has, over the last 4 years, been taking the brunt of the Syrian conflict with some over 2.3, 2.5 million Syrians actually being in Turkey. And we have, to a certain extent, comfortably looked away and said, the Turks are taking care of that, and we don't need to bother about that.
Notre relation avec la Turquie, j'espère qu'on pourra la construire sur un peu plus de confiance. Parfois c'est difficile, ça c'est clair. Difficile peut-être pour les Turcs, mais aussi difficile pour nous.
Yes, we have to engage with Turkey because they have to make sure that irregular migration no longer takes place from Turkey to the Greek islands.
The Commission here negotiated already in October a draft action plan with a view to get a complete agreement with Turkey.
The Commission have actually developed a joint action program, which has a number of different elements. An openness in as much as the enlargement negotiations are concerned, and then an overall discussion on visa liberalization.
Our key role was to make sure that what had been negotiated between the Commission and Turkey would also be acceptable to all 28 member states. That was not an easy task. We do need all member states on board, otherwise it won't work.
Let me state clearly that we do not expect anyone to guard our borders for us, but we expect a major step when it comes to stemming the migration flow that is coming to the EU via Turkey. We will also step up our assistance to Syrian refugees in Turkey through a new refugee facility of 3 billion euros.
C'est clair pour moi, les 3 milliards, on ne les donne pas au président turc ou au premier ministre turc ou au gouvernement turc, on les donne pour que 2 millions de réfugiés syriens puissent avoir une perspective, avoir un travail en Turquie.
It is too early to say that it is bearing fruit. The glass is not full, but it's not empty either.
President Tusk said early on in the crisis, we need to regain control of our external borders, or it will be very difficult to get rid of the temporary internal border controls that have been put in place.
Nous avons un bien commun qui est la libre circulation à l'intérieur de l'espace dit Schengen. Ça ne peut fonctionner que si les frontières extérieures de l'Union européenne sont contrôlées. Mais si ce contrôle n'est pas correctement assuré, tout le monde est perdant. Et donc, il faut aider les pays à assurer correctement le contrôle des frontières extérieures.
The December European Council dealt with the proposal put forward by the Commission for a common border and coast guard, and that had a reception by the leaders that was even more positive than I would have expected.
We will have a new European Border Guard Agency, which will be the follower to Frontex, hopefully.
Il faut se rendre compte ce que c'est Schengen. C'est le marché commun, c'est la libre circulation, c'est l'Europe du citoyen. Tout ça s'écroulera si Schengen est parti. Et c'est one shot. Une fois parti, ça ne reviendra plus.
Most meetings in the European Council are about things that really matter. Sometimes there are tensions, and that goes, of course, in particular for an issue like migration.
Sur cette crise-là, il y a des enjeux politiques très très forts nationaux dans presque tous les États membres. On voit bien tous les chefs d'État. Ils ont un engagement personnel. Ils ont, au niveau national, des pressions, des difficultés, des questions. Ils doivent répondre à leurs opinions publiques.
Their preparation is very important because preparation can contribute to ensuring that no one among the heads are surprised. They know already beforehand where we are heading. But the meeting is as such, while sometimes taking place in a politically charged atmosphere, there's a strong collective understanding that the heads need to find solutions. Therefore, heads act very responsibly and work towards solutions.
Ce sont des enjeux qui interpellent très directement les citoyens et donc, je dirais, qui ont un certain impact sur la manière dont les élections se gagnent ou se perdent.
And some would often say that what we are doing is too little and too late. But the Union does have 28 member states and we need to have member states on board. Otherwise, what we do will have no consequence, will not be implemented, will not work. And that is actually at the core of what we are doing. All the time trying to create real compromises.
Au niveau du Conseil, il y avait quand même un appui très très fort. Et je dois dire aussi qu'au niveau des pays, au téléphone, on pouvait parler en Corée. Tous les gens, même ceux qui avaient une autre position.
I personally think that we will be able to solve this crisis as we have solved previous crises. That is my firm conviction. It will probably take some time. I think that it will, along the way, be a rough ride, but I'm absolutely confident that at the end we will find solutions also here, and we will find solutions by doing more in common than we did before we came into this crisis. That is the normal evolution in European integration.
Güncel konusu da etkin, adil ve insancıl bir iltica politikası oluşturmaktır. Bunun için de ortak Avrupa sığınma sisteminin yenilenmesi gerekmektedir. Değişikliklerin amacı, sığınma talebinde bulunan üye ülkelerin eşit ve uygun muamele görmelerini garanti altına almaktır. Avrupa Birliği, uluslararası koruma altına alınan adayların entegrasyonunu hızlandırmak için iltica sürecini kısaltmak ve sadeleştirmek niyetinde. Şimdiye dek 511 Suriyeli mülteci Türkiye'den alınarak Avrupa'daki yeni evlerine yerleştirildi.
أنا طلعت بال 2014. أنا من الرقة فهي صارت بعدين عاصمة داعش. إجانا تهديد إنه داعش عرفت إنه نحن بتركيا. إجانا تهديد عن طريق النت إنه نحن عرفنا أنتوا وين قاعدين. فلا تفكروا إنه نحن ما فينا نوصلكم.
بالعكس يعني أنا دائما بشكر الله إنه نحنا يعني من دونا عن غيرنا اتاحت لنا الفرصة أن نجي لهون ونكون ونحقق مستقبل أفضل لأطفالي.
الهدف كان بس بدنا أمان، بس بدنا حياة أفضل، بس بدنا سلام، بدنا مستقبل، كونه صارت حرب، صار دمار، فلهيك جينا هون.
وبعتقد انه كثير من المؤسسات اللي بتساعد الناس لما بيجوا لهون لحتى يقدروا يعني يكون في اندماج بالمجتمع، وهذا الشيء حصلنا عليه من بداية وجودنا هون وما زلنا عم نحصل عليه، هيدا اللي عم يعطينا دائما دفع بحياتنا هون.
بالمستقبل بتمنى انه يكون اني كمل دراستي وخلص واتخرج. بتمنى اني فيد هولندا، وبتمنى انه يصير سلام بسوريا واني ارجع واخدم سوريا بالشيء اللي انا فيني اعمله.
We'll be right back. Sığınmacılar Avrupa'da hoş karşılanıyor mu? Mayıs ayında Strasbourg Parlamentosu'nda gerçekleştirilen 2016 Avrupa Gençlik Buluşması'nın başlığı da buydu. Bu buluşmada Avrupa'nın dört bir yanından gelen gençler, savaştan kaçan Suriyeli gençlerin kabus dolu hikayelerini dinleme imkanı buldular.
Salam aleykum. Ahle ve sahle. Peace be with you. You are very welcome in Europe. When I worked in a refugee camp in Chios, I witnessed the building of one of the hotspots, detention centers, what you would like to call them. And I saw a process of hope change to a process of despair. When they arrived first, before the detention centers, people were afraid, but they were hopeful. They had what they needed. They moved on. After the detention centers, people were left in a situation with not enough information. They weren't sufficiently safe or protected by the police. They weren't even given enough food, water, and these things are still going on. I witnessed this with my own eyes, and it made me wonder, have we as the European Union perhaps failed ourselves in this instance regarding our core values? Today we've talked about democracy, inclusion, tolerance, solidarity, peace, protection of human rights. So I think we need to ask ourselves, have we let ourselves down here?
15 March 2015, I lost my contact with my mother for 3 days. Then later she called me, she said, I'm in Turkey. She went from Aleppo to Turkey, she walked 12 kilometers, and she is 64 years old, and she went to Turkey in illegal way, because she couldn't, it was the only way. She sent me out of Syria in 2012, because she said, it's not safe for you anymore, I was young and in the age of war. So she stayed there and she fought for 5 years in her house. She didn't want to move, but she found a time that she must move, and she moved. Are you telling me this woman is searching for a job or better life? No, for sure not. She is not searching.
They've made into a surgery. I left my country because I was running after my career as a swimmer. And now with the war there in Syria, there is no future with swimming anymore. I decided to go on this journey with my little sister, Yisra. She's 18 years old. Like everyone, we took the airplane from Damascus Airport to get to Istanbul, Turkey. After we arrived at Istanbul, Turkey, we took the bus, which was organized by the smuggler, to Izmir, Turkey. We stayed in the jungle for 4 days without any food or water, waiting for the turn to take the boat to Lesbos Island in Greece. Finally, our turn came. We were 20 persons in a boat for 7 people. Me and my sister and one woman from Somalia, and 17 men with a little kid. At the beginning, when I was in Izmir, in the island, I said for my sister, okay, if we drown down, just swim. Don't save anyone. Don't care for anyone. Swim next to me and we will be safe. So at the beginning, everything was going well. After 15 minutes, the motor stopped. I saw tears in everyone's eyes. The voices start to be so loud, and everyone was terrified. A man decided to go in the water. As a professional swimmer, I used to work a lifeguard in Syria in swimming pools, so I decided to go in the water with this man. Everyone was watching me like, I'm a woman. What I will do for help 17 men? And everyone was making jokes about me. After 3 hours from swimming, trying and pushing, we get at Lesbos Island in Greece. For me as a swimmer, it was so horrible experience.
I'm a refugee for the second time. My grandparents, they came from Palestine in 1948, and ever since they didn't get back. They moved to Syria, Damascus, the capital, and we lived in Al Yarmouk camp, which is basically for the Palestinian refugees in Syria. In 2012, Al-Yarmouk camp turned into a battlefield between all the parties. And afterwards, as a result, almost 600,000 people out of them, out of the whole population, were out in one day. You cannot imagine this picture. I will not forget it till the end of my life. Almost all the people, we have one highway there. You almost see only heads of people. The street was full of people, elderly, women, children, young people, all of them carrying all just the bags, all the sacks. Okay, 600,000 people in one day we were out. And now Al-Yarmouk camp is occupied by Al-Qaeda and IS till the moment.
Bugünlük bu kadar. Bir sonraki bölümü kaçırmayın. Çünkü Avrupa Birliği politikaları birliğe bağlı kurumlar ve projeler hakkında ilginç hikayelerle biz yine burada olacağız.